Hello and welcome back, everybody. Picking up where we left off with the landed UFO in what looks like London, England. And we're gonna launch the mission, even though we got a couple of. I was speaking, Karen. God damn it. Every robot announced lady is gonna be called Karen from this point on. Thank you, SpongeBob. How the hell are you gonna land in France and then things? Alright, how ye is here, why can how ye not have things? So you got a spider suit, which is cool. We'll be able to check that out for once. Give you a nanoscale vest as well. Oh, Jester, you're the one with the damn... The thing. I know what I was talking about. Did you? I did. And instead of you having one of those... I need to build them, don't I? Hang on. I can't. Damn it! I wanted to build the thing! Son of a bitch! Son of a bitch! I can't get clean! I want my own night! Alright, I'm done. two grenadiers. Alright, yeah, this will be fine. Two snipers, one and one. My usual setup. Except for now I have psyops, so I usually trade out one of the snipers for the psyops.
Sky Ranger deployed. Squad green to deploy.
Yes, death wheel or death wheat? Did I hear death wheat? Death meat. Come on, good thing. It's getting kind of dark in here. I'm gonna go ahead and turn on my light.
Resistance forces managed to disable a UFO.
Death wheel. Damn it! I don't want death wheel. Wilderness of Western Europe. Well, apparently England counts as the wilderness of Western Europe. Just saw you all know. Oh, so I was watching Family Feud a couple days ago, and the question, it was on the Fast Money, so the question was, what is the most beautiful country? And I swear to God, they couldn't have got the any dumber people in the world. The first lady said Paris. Paris is not a country. Paris is the capital of a country called France, but it's not a country. So that was wrong. The second lady, her daughter, her first answer was Paris, but since the other person had said Paris, you had to give another answer.
Not a copy.
And then her second answer was Rome. Rome was an empire at one point, I guess. Italy's the country that Rome is in. I swear to God, it's country, not city. Oh, I could have done grapple. I could have showed off the spider armor. But I didn't, because I thought I was Truman. I'm going to blame Truman for that one. His fault, not mine.
Will do.
Oh, but yeah, I swear people are so fucking dumb sometimes. And you'd be like, oh, it's an honest mistake. No, because then she tried to argue that Rome was a country. Oh, man.
On the move.
Just damn. Oh lordy. Oh lordy Jesus. Can't do it. We haven't taken Jester with us in a long time because I don't like Jester. Jester annoys the shit out of me. Why? Because she misses. Every fucking time.
Let's do this.
Let's move Tickle up with old How Yi. Chinese bald gangbanger. So we gotta face one of those fucking eggshell things. I hate them. Stupid little bastards. So, grapple. We could get you over here, and this is a free movement. So, you know what? I'm actually gonna do it. Show you all what it does.
Whee!
It's like the claw hook from fucking Legend of Zelda. Except for it's a lot more accurate. I blame the controllers. There's nothing like playing a Zelda game or any old Nintendo game where it's very, very precise movement is required and your controller just doesn't do what you want it to do sometimes because, you know, they weren't as... I'm not going to say good because they were good controllers, but they weren't as refined. Like, I swear to God, the dead zone for some of them joysticks is a bit off. Just a bit. So I can't move there without getting spotted. I don't like that. But I can move there. Then go into Overwatch.
Scanning.
Then I can move Jester over here. Scanning protocol can trigger drone and scan of an area, increasing specialist sight radius substantially for one turn, revealing any hidden targets. That's kind of cool. And Overwatch. And then we're gonna move AL Tickly Man over here, and then Pistol Overwatch. Okay. So, we're gonna expose Ronin just a teensy weensy bit. We're gonna stick you in Overwatch. We're going to go kill zone over here. Hang on. Nope. Anyway, you're gonna get spotted. Okay, don't like that. Stick you on Overwatch. We're gonna trigger with him. We'll move her up. We'll stick you on Overwatch. And then Braidenwood, go ahead and start the fireworks. I got eaten up by fucking mosquitoes. Can't stop itching. Like, I counted a total of 7 bites. Fucking hate it. Aw, oh, come on, Ronin. Why do you do this to me? Come on, get it. There you go. Alright, how ye has got a promotion. Where do you go, how ye?
Is it clear?
So I was playing with Plinkin and How Ye today on How Ye server. And we were doing the Empire versus Rome at the Beach of Troy, so I was like, I've showed this a lot. So I'm not gonna go ahead and show it again this soon. So we were just playing, we got to wave 35, but How Ye picked okay, I have no idea what that exploded. Hang on, I can't even fucking think right now. How Ye got enough to get a hero class, so he picked Joan of Arc, which, as you all know, is the French maiden who did things and stuff. Things and stuff. But the reason is she has some of the best armor in the game, and the Flambridge, which is an OP as fuck sword.
Maybe a flesh wound.
And it gives his character a complete female model, except for his face. So you got a female-ish looking knight who has got a bearded face, and I was walking up behind him. I was healing, I think. I can't even remember at this point. I just fucking... Why did you miss, you stupid fuckface? I'm really bad. Tell him, shut up.
I'm going.
Your backpack's too small. Shut up. Shut up, Harry. I don't like. But, the point of the story, get to the point. He has a character model that is female. So he has a female butt. I was right behind him. Like, literally all I could see was his butt on my screen. That was it. So I was like, "How are you? You have a very plump butt today." And he turned around. He started trying to kick me. And then Blinken comes in like 2 minutes later. He's like, "Oh yeah, I kind of noticed that today." just some of the shit we do on there, man. Having a good old time. Alright, go ahead and kill him. Now I gotta deal with the suit. You know that was good. I feel like all the extra damage you do should go to the suit. Like, I wish you could pick which thing you would like to hit, the alien inside or the suit. Because if you kill the suit, the alien's obviously gonna die. You know what? You're too far down. We're gonna move you over here. And moving you over here. Because we do need to disable this distress beacon. Would probably be a good idea. Let's move Tickle up over here. There's no way his pistol would reach anyways. We have one person on Overwatch. Of course you miss. Why wouldn't you miss? I mean, I shouldn't expect anybody to hit anyways. No way it'll kill it. What the fuck's going on? So, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna run and gun here.
No problem, boss.
And then, like the genius I am, move him right here. Then, I'll go ahead and fire the weapon. I just really didn't want to walk through that acid.
Well, how about that?
And that could have been seen as a waste of a running gun, but hey, he didn't get wounded, killed it anyways. Good thing in my book. Dude, on top of the tree, do it. I don't even care at this point. Yep, you're on top of the fucking tree. Don't even care right now.
Seems doable.
Okay, go ahead. Overwatch. Please open said door. Oh, hello. What are you doing in there? Oh, you didn't like that, did you? No, I don't think I did. And kill it. Don't miss. Oh, thank God. They always seem to miss the moment I need them to not miss. And stick Truman on Overwatch, and then Central's gonna come on. Yeah. Oh, no, he didn't come on. Well, prove me wrong. Oh, you're just gonna stay there, man. That's just fucking perfect. With old Jester. You know what? I'm gonna risk it.
Got it. Moving.
Menace 1-5, that's the distress beacon. Move in and disable it before the aliens get a bead on the UFO.
Shut up. I am doing things and stuff.
I'm going.
Things and stuff is better than whatever you're doing. Longwatch.
Moving to Overwatch.
I don't even care that he has absolutely no cover. That is the perfect position, and nobody can tell me otherwise from battlefield sniping. Everybody else is wrong. That is the perfect position. Truman will agree with me.
On the move.
Then Overwatch.
Moving to Overwatch. Whatever you say.
The hell are these aliens at?
On Overwatch.
Don't care. Nope. The thing.
Accessing system.
Recover small cache. Wow, really? This is supposed to be my hacking one, remember? I'm supposed to be my hacking specialist. Gonna get more than fucking 15%.
The alien distress signal. Looks like the skies are quiet.
Huh?
And Overwatch.
On Overwatch.
IE is just gonna stay here forever. I mean,
Overwatch.
I'm not joking. I love it too much.
I can handle that.
Oh, really? Fuck, just clotheslined him like. Okay, that will damage both of them. I don't know how this is gonna work, but it will. So what I learned from last time is those little poopy alien bots are mean. I don't like the egg-shelled testicles. Not at all. More grenades. Kill the sectoid. Shred more armor. Apparently, I was too far.
Got it.
Then I guess it's time to move the snipers up. What are you gonna do? I'm gonna bash through the wall. Are you doing Void Rift again? You are. What are you doing too, though? You fucking suck. Ah. Well, that makes me feel better.
Will do.
Whew. No. If I'm grappling hooking anywhere. I guess I'm not grappling hooking nowhere. We'll be right over here.
I'm on the move.
And go ahead, fire the weapon. You really suck. You really built that character wrong. Should always give every single grenadier shred. It's just every single one of them needs it.
No problem, boss.
It's the best thing to get rid of armor sometimes.
Deflection. Get in the water here.
Let's go ahead and fire. How do you still have armor?
Hard target. Minimal damage. Need a resupply.
On the move.
Okay, somebody's gonna get hurt. Somebody is gonna get hurt. Maybe it'll kill itself. Oh, I've seen enough anime to know where tentacles and little women go. I know where that's going and I don't like it. I need somebody that can get... Oh, you're out of ammo. Gotcha. Gotcha, gotcha, gotcha. So, we'll just go ahead and hurt you. Okay, wasn't expecting a critical. Ronin, that was not the good time for the critical. Because they explode. I just wanted to damage it so Joker could, or Jester could get the kill. To get the XP, but they just decided, fuck it, I'll just kill it. Whoops. Just a whoopsie moment there. Yes, I keep forgetting to change their fucking helmets. Alright, I'm doing that tonight. Doing it right now. Doing it right now. As soon as we get back. Alright, come on, you can, you know, load faster than that. Gravely wounded. I'd be really, really surprised if you weren't. Alright.
I told the troops to expect the best, and that's what you
lightly. Seriously? Okay.
Well done.
What is this? Launch or throwing a grenade using heavy weapon with your first action will not end your turn. Sounds fine with me. Promote how ye hidden ability locked. Your sniper rifle attacks shred armor. Thank God. Every kill you make, I like this. It's free action. I don't know how in the hell. Aid protocol now grants the target covering fire overwatch shot, but aid protocol cools down increased by one. Finally. Don't know how in the hell he got out of there, is lightly wounded. So what I'm doing right now is sitting bear, customize, props, helmet. No more. Ooh, that looks cool. It matches, at least. We're gonna go ahead and give you that one. And then do Braidenwood. Alright, customize. Character. Oops. Damn it. I'm shit at this. I know. Helmet. What the fucking what? That's awful looking. Jesus. You shall be getting Warden 2. Yeah. Alright, now I have not forgotten. Ooh. So that is done. Reduce contact costs. Let's do it. I know we were doing the alien alloys before, but reduce contact costs is nice. Because I have no supplies right now. And I'm running out of contacts.
I am sure you will find the results to be
yes!
intriguing as I do.
I just need supplies. Okay, we'll do the storm gun now. Full plasma technology.
I'll contact you when
for
I
weapons, at least.
Available.
What are you staring at me like that for? Let's see, what else can we get you? Soulfire. Does guaranteed sonic damage to organic enemy and ignores cover and armor. Ooh, I like that. Alright. Idle staff proving ground. Well, I have no supplies.
Priority message coming through, Commander. Putting it on screen now.
You have made considerable progress against the aliens over the past month, Commander. I hope that your ongoing efforts will only lead to further success.
100 encryption. The aliens are on high alert, making it harder for XCOM to catch them unaware. We'll definitely do the chrysalid one. I don't like chrysalids. Not right now. We're doing the reduced contact.
I've made a number of interesting discoveries, Commander.
Okay. And
this specimen,
I shall be right back.
Henceforth referred to as the Gatekeeper, seems to harbor considerable psionic power. As with the alien's other unique biomechanical field unit, it will take some time to decipher the systems involved in its function.
You forgot to say that it's an eggshell testicle. That's what you were really meaning to say. Don't care. Okay, doke. Yes, go get to the supply drop. Are we going up to Scandinavia and Finland? Or Sweden? Well, I mean, technically that entire region is called Scandinavia. Screw it. Finland! Or no, that's Sweden. I think. Yeah, I think that's in Sweden. It's very hard. Very hard to tell. Alright, you got that. Soul Steel. Soul Fire transfers half damage. Done. Back to the Psyops Opera. It's health! That's fucking cool! How do they teach him these things, is my question. Alright. So, we're going back in here, and you know what we're doing? We're going straight to engineering. Why are we going straight to engineering? To do this. Build, and we're broke. I don't care.
I saw Tygen muttering to himself in one of the corridors. I'm not sure he even noticed me. Bradford trusts him, but I'm still...
Well, he's crazy. Experimental powered weapon. Or I think plasma grenades are going to do us more good.
I'll send word when the project is complete.
Yes. So now, we go get the alien alloys.
Avenger plotting new course.
And after that, we'll call the episode... Making good progress. Alright, continue the training. What's... No Lance. Project a beam of terrible power that damages every target it passes through. The attack can penetrate multiple enemies and obstacles. These are cool. I like psyops. First I thought they were going
to
be useless.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander. I have come to suspect that this creature's unusual appearance is somehow directly connected to its notable
alien
psyamp.
Alright.
The aliens always...
Let us go to the shadow chamber.
Their actions, even as twisted as it is often revealed to be.
Alright. So we got Codex data, recover advent stasis. We'll do this. Yes. I have no more research that I feel needs to be done. That's the very moment, and we can finally progress in the storyline.
Strategic resource located.
Ooh, investigate.
Avenger plotting new
Lots
course.
Of supplies. So we'll get that, then we'll call the episode. I have one more minute anyways. Yeah! Plus, it'll get a whole bunch of stuff done.
Just like the one we found the commander in.
On the surface, yes. But in function. Ah, Commander, excellent. We can begin. It is no secret that Advent soldiers possess both human and alien genetic characteristics. Preliminary analysis led me to believe that this was the result of direct modifications made to a pre-existing human host. Prisoners, or perhaps even unwitting volunteers.
See your local Advent recruiter today.
However, the reality is something else entirely. The Advent troopers at the facility we discovered, including the specimen before you, were manufactured. Each soldier possesses a unique genetic code. Predominantly human, of course, but with some fragments left open.
Left open for what?
Whatever alien DNA Advent wishes to insert. Sectoid, muton, even the species our soldiers refer to as berserker. In all cases, human genetic material serves as a bonding agent, holding the strands together.
Human material? You mean the stuff we found at the Blacksite facility?
Precisely. The key component in their soldier manufacturing process.
So we've been fighting ourselves this entire time.
In a way. But I believe there's more to it than that. The human DNA in this specimen bears one key difference from the entirety of the sequences decoded in the Shadow Chamber. Psionic sensitivity. Given the sheer volume of strands involved, This cannot be accidental.
Screening process at the clinics. Avatar.
The potential power of a being created with this template is significant. Central. Had we not intercepted it before the process was completed...
I know, Doctor. Continue your research. Let us know if you find anything else.
Well. Spooky stuff. Alright, let's just finish this up. God damn it! Soul Steel. Solace. The psyop is surrounded by an aura that immediately extinguishes or blocks any mental impairments for themselves and nearby squadmates. Oh, I like this. Like all the things. I just really want to get this thing done, and then I'm going to call the episode. Plasma grenade done. Cool. Advanced explosives. We don't have supplies. Ignore. I don't know if I can do them later. I can't. Alright, so I'm just going to go ahead and call it here, guys. No way I'm going to get that done. So, this has been Raging Ronin. If you all like the videos, like the series, let me know in the comments below. Leave a thumbs up. Continue watching the videos fully. However you want to help out the channel, I always appreciate it. Subscribe if you want to see more. I'll see y'all next time.